Pray for our president, Muhammadu, the vice president, Oshibaju. Pray for the governor of Lagos State, Babajide, and all those in authority, that the Lord God Almighty will lead them in righteous path to be able to direct us and make this country livable and prosperous. Let us pray for the church, especially the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Let's pray for our primate, Henry, the dean, Buba, and the Archbishop of the province of Lagos, who is late, but yet to be buried. Let's pray for his family. Let's pray for the Diocese of Lagos. Let's pray for the province of Lagos, for comfort of the Holy Spirit. Let's pray for our bishop, in particular, Akinpelu Johnson of Diocese of Lagos, Mainland, that the Lord will be with him. As we lift up All Saints Church Abba into the hands of the Lord, pray that the Spirit of the Lord will continually dwell among us through the ministers and those that have been ministered to. Let us pray for our choir. That the reason why we are here today, we are celebrating the 79th annual choir festival. Many of them were not here when the choir started, but the choir has metamorphosized. And today there are still descendants and children still standing in the gap. Pray that the Lord will use them even to pass out the gospel to the next generation. Pray for their leader, the organist, the choir master. And pray for yourself. Ask God to do it again, that by this time next year, I will be here in the land of the living, if Christ tarries, to witness another Advent season and choir festival, the 80th anniversary. The Lord respects such prayers. Say, Lord, if you tarry, I will be here to celebrate with the choir in the 80th year anniversary. It's a covenant and God keeps it. Cover yourself now with the blood of Jesus and pray that all your heart desires shall be granted by the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and thus promise that when two or three are gathered together in your name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Our God deserves to be praised and to be celebrated for the privilege that you and me were alive to witness another Advent. And to us in the church, this is the beginning of a new year. And if you are convinced that the Lord has been so good to you, could you please give the Lord a celebration with clap? Father, our hearts are filled with thanks and praise, and that we have celebrated and demonstrated in the giving of offerings of clap. Lord, we ask and we pray that as we look at your word, in this service of thanks and praise, you will speak to us. Enable in us a singing culture, that our lives become what you wanted it to be. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shout hallelujah. I'm glad to appreciate, as I recognize, all our guests, all of us that we have invited, and you have honored us from your various parishes to celebrate the gift of singing, to celebrate along with us that which matters most to God. My prayer is that as you have honored us, our God will honor you in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me praise God as I commend the choir of all saints for the preparations that they have made to have this beautiful ministration today. My prayer is that just in the manner that you have given us beautiful ministration, the Lord shall make your lives beautiful. In the name of Jesus Christ. Everybody who makes sacrifice to this beautiful outing, we pray that that which you have done, the Lord shall reward. In the name of Jesus. The theme for anniversary this year looks very open-ended. Sing. Sing. And is from the book of Psalm, chapter 96, verse 1. And that was the Old Testament lesson that was read. And we saw it in verse 1. And it says, Psalm 96, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. When I look at the theme, I was wondering, how do we address this an open-ended theme? How do we make sure that the theme communicates to us the mind and the expectation of God? How do we make sure that we do not go theoretical, but we knock on that which God wants us to hear? Because when you are talking about sing, sing what? After all, people sing all kind of songs. But to guide this sermon, to sing means to produce musical tunes and tones by means of the voice. It means to utter words in musical tones and with musical inflections and modulations. It means to deliver songs as a trained professional singers. It means to make shrill whining or whistling sound. And it also means to relate or celebrate something in verse, like composing poetry. It also means to produce musical or harmonious sounds. And looking at this definition, I want to lay a foundation to what God asked me to share with us that singing has a major psychological impact of facts. And this is, singing releases oxytocin and endorphins. These are little feel-good hormones that trigger happiness in our brain. And the importance of this psychological impact is that Satan knows the secret that singing brings excitement. And how? The biology of behavior tells us that endorphins exist to inhibit pain. Signals in the brain, and it can produce a feeling of euphoria, where you feel so high, you feel so elated, you have a feeling of ecstasy, and you have a feeling of high heaven. Singing is a psychosocial engagement which research has proven to improve social support, increase positive emotions, and reduce fatigue and stress. And I think this should be telling us that singing is a beautiful thing that God has given unto us. Singing stimulates multiple areas of the brain at the same time. And with the little I've said about singing, permit me to raise an alarm on singing here. The stimulability of the brain through singing is the secret of the spirituality of singing. The part of man that responds and longs for singing is a deliberate design of God. And that is why one of the greatest singers in the history of humanity, in the Bible, David, said in Psalm 149 verse 4, that I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knows right well. People of God, permit me to say here this evening that research is yet to fully exhaust and reveal all that man can do or become, either good or bad. And because Satan knows this secret of what singing is to God and to man, he manipulates man into other engagements that tickles that same part of the brain that always significantly responds to singing. I believe everybody here, we are all here because we appreciate and we love to sing. And these feel-good emotions can be achieved as people submit themselves to become alcoholics, submit themselves to smoking, submit themselves to gambling, submit themselves to everything that looks like it makes them feel good now. And because Satan knows that when man feels regularly good or high, there's a tendency to feel satisfied, happy, and comfortable. And that is why he manipulates us into things that make us feel good, but the end is always a calamity. And that is why in the church today, singing group, singing community has become a major task to handle, to lead, to coordinate. Go and ask the choir masters how easy it is for them to lead the choir, to lead member of the choir. For you to lead the choir, you need special grace of God. Not only special grace of God, you must be a worthy example. And to death, you will realize how properly our lives are arranged, even in sequence. Why? Because we are a reflection of God's being. The Bible says we are created in his image and likeness. All Saint Choir, Montgomery Road, Yaba, in our anniversary today, says to everybody in this service that we are meant to be a singing content to God. Likewise, we are meant to be a God-singing being. And towards this, Paul said in the New Testament lesson that was read this evening, Ephesians chapter 5, from verse 16, there are a few things Paul counseled that we must be conscious of, and this must be part of us for our singing life to become a thing that God celebrates along with us. From verse 15, the Bible says, be careful then how you live. Everybody who is involved in singing in the church, the Bible says you must be careful how you live, not as unwise people, but as wise. That tells you a thing. You cannot be like others because you are a carrier of holy mystery. Number 2, in verse 17, the Bible says, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. What is the will of God for your life? The will of God for your life is that you are a singing content and you are a God song. Number 3, in verse 18, the Bible says, do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery. Hello? I hope somebody is hearing me. Are you hearing me? But instead of being filled with wine, the Bible says, be filled with the Holy Spirit. Because it is in being careful, in being wise in the way you live, it is in choosing a path, negative, different, going not the same direction in the path of the fools, that as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, as we have done today, singing and making melody to the Lord in your hearts, then you will not just sing for singing's sake. According to verse 20, it is then you will give thanks to God. It is then you give thanks to God, the Father of all times, and for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus. People of God, I want to say to us this evening that when we come to a realization that we are a God's song. And we are called to make a life that is a singing unto God. Then singing becomes natural, regular, and frequent to you. Now the comfort that you derive from this singing goes beyond a triggered feeling, happy hormones that come occasionally. It goes beyond feeling high for a moment and it just ends there. It goes beyond feeling ecstasy, ecstatic for a few seconds and it just disappears. Why? The Bible says in Psalm 22 verse 3, Psalm 22 verse 3, and I look at two versions of the Bible, and these two versions of the Bible say something that is very, very relevant to what we are seeing here. KJV said, God inhabits the praise of his people. NIV, an American Standard Version, say this. They express it this way: God is enthroned on the praise and praises of his people. People of God, what this means to us is that when you sing to God, you build a throne for him. When your life becomes a singing to God, then you become a throne for God. And what do you think will be the effect of this? I say to people who cares to hear that the most consistently assured minister in the church of being blessed by God at the choir. Why? Because as they sing from the scripture, as they sing from our hymn books, God speaks to them. But the problem is that on many occasions, as God speaks to us, we don't hear. We don't hear. Look at the songs that were sung this evening, the psalms that we have rendered in praise this evening. Through these psalms, the Lord administered to us. So if, while you are preparing to lead the congregation, to sing this God representing himself, God will have ministered to you, encouraged you before others gathered. So when you are talking of fresh blessing, fresh meal, fresh meat spiritually, that is exclusively reserved for the choir. Please give the Lord a clap offering for as many that are involved in singing in the church. Because even when we do not commend you, you have marked yourself for blessing. Even when we do not praise you, you have marked yourself, because God will never forget your labor of proclaiming him, your labor of celebrating him, your labor of amplifying his goodness in your lives. So when your life becomes a throne for God, what is the effect? In Matthew chapter 21 from verse 1, the same story there is in Mark 11 verse 1 and Luke chapter 19 verse 28. It contains the story of the triumphant entry. And at the event of the triumphant entry, there are two major things I want to call your attention to there. Jesus and the hearse that he rose to Jerusalem. When Jesus rode on ass to Jerusalem, on the way to Jerusalem, people pluck leaves, palm fronds, and some even took off their cloth and lay it on the floor. While they were doing that, I want to ask you a question. Who are they honoring? I'm asking, who are they honoring? Jesus now. They were celebrating Jesus. But as they were celebrating Jesus, putting leaves, palm fronds, and their cloth on the floor for the donkey who carried Jesus, that carried Jesus, to walk on, something came to my mind. The donkey share in that glory. Did you hear me? The donkey share in what? In that glory. When somebody is an ambassador of a country in another nation, every honor, every reference, every respect due to the head of state of that nation is given to that ambassador. When you come to understand what the Choir of All Saints is saying this year, you register yourself, you enlist yourself on the list of God's ambassador. And that then means every glory of God demonstrated among humanity, your share is guaranteed. Your share is guaranteed. But for this to be, the Bible says, you sing unto the Lord a new song. What forms a new song that we sing unto the Lord? A new life. A life that colored Jesus. A life that propels Jesus. That life, sing a new song. I pray for you this evening that while you live, the Lord will bring you to the understanding of what we are saying. And you will not only be involved in singing, but you will become a singing unto God in the name of Jesus. You shall become God's song among humanity in the name of Jesus. Let's close eyes for prayer. Thank you, Jesus, for this short exhortation. I pray for everyone under this message that you will reinterpret this short exhortation to us. You will water and breathe upon this short exhortation in our lives. Lord, we ask that this which we have said in your name shall bring forth fruits unto singing of your praise, demonstration of your glory in our lives. For we pray in Jesus' name.
Lord,
Praise ye the Lord. We have in our midst at this festival of praise a representative of the Joshua Okewo Foundation.
Good evening, church. Good evening, officiating ministers. Okay, my name is Mrs. Tolulola Babarinde. To the glory of God, I'm the chairperson of the Church Musicians Benevolent Foundation. Now, the Church Musicians Benevolent Foundation is a foundation that has been established to cater for the general well-being of church musicians, namely choristers, organists, instrumentalists, and the masters of music. The foundation was established in the year 2020. And during COVID, to the glory of God, we were able to give out food packs to over 12,000 choristers in Lagos, Ogun, and Oyo states. And this was sponsored by the Joshua Okewo Foundation. Joshua Okewo is a member of the Board of Trustees of the Church Musicians Benevolent Foundation. We have also paid medical expenses of some sick church musicians, and I've started awarding scholarships to support the education of church musicians, organists and choristers at the primary, secondary and the tertiary level. This evening, I'm here on behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Foundation to present an award to a chorister of this great church. Now, the award will cover the beneficiary, I understand, is present, is in primary schools, about to round up his primary school education. So as from January, by God's grace, the foundation will take up the education of the chorister, will support in terms of tuition fees and other levies that we may consider to be appropriate. So we will support the completion of his primary school education, extend it to the secondary school education. It is our desire to also produce graduates, and as such, by God's grace, we will sponsor his university education. Okay, the beneficiary of this scholarship is no other person than young, vibrant, and brilliant Master Korede Badamosi. Award shall be forwarded to you through the choir master of the church, Mr. Tope Olagunju. Please permit us to sing this hymn, All Things Are Possible to Him That Believe, to the tune Stamford. Thank you.
At this time, we would like to invite the patrons of the choir for their special rendition. Please, let's welcome them.
The next hymn for collection, the gift of stewards will come around to take the collection from your hands. May God bless you as you give generously in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. On page 19, number 19, on page 19, very, very crucial and important. The choir will be giving us hymns why collection will be made in the aid of the choir funds. That's why it's very, very important. And it has a special number, it's 1919. So you know what to do. May God bless you as you support the choir. God will also support you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Good evening, everybody. I am overwhelmed. I'm so overwhelmed with the crowd, the response from the audience and everybody. Thank you very much for coming. I have a written list here and I just have to follow it. Please excuse me. Okay, my first appreciation goes to God Almighty. I want to appreciate God for the success of this program. It hasn't been easy, and without God, it is impossible to achieve anything at all. And I would like to say a very big thank you to our vicar, the doctor, Venerable Dr. Femi Fasile. Thank you, sir, for everything. Thank you for always supporting the choir and always taking care of us and indulging us. Thank you very much, sir. May God continue to bless you. I would also like to thank the assisting priests. I would like to start with our chaplains. I would like to start with Reverend Ogungbe. Thank you very much for your support, sir. And the assistant chaplain, Reverend Oshinibi, thank you for your support. I'd like to thank Venerable Ogundile. Thank you very much, sir, for your support and your constant advice. And finally, I would like to say a big thank you to Canon Charles Oguka, who was the cantor tonight. Please, let's... All right, I got the list. It is very rare to find priests who can do responses unaccompanied from start to bottom. Please, let's appreciate the canon one more time. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you. I would like to thank the management of the church and the wardens of the church. A very, very big thank you to you, sirs. Your support is awesome, it's wonderful. I really want to thank you. I want to thank the wardens, sir. The people's warden, thank you very much, sir. And the vicar's warden, thank you for your support. Thank you for your financial support. You will not get tired of us in Jesus' name. We will keep coming and you will keep granting our requests in Jesus' name. Thank you, sir. I would also like to thank the music committee of the church, headed by Professor Tokunbo Tayo. He's out of the country at the moment. Thank you very much, the music committee. I'd like to say a very big thank you to our patrons. I don't know if I should call them the choristers of the church. Please, a round of applause for our patrons. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you very much. They've been here since morning and they waited. We even practiced a few minutes to this service. Thank you very much. God will always continue to bless you. Thank you. We'd like to say a big thank you to the societies of the day. Thank you very much. You heeded our invitation on short notice. Thank you very much. God bless you. Thank you. I'd like to say a big thank you to the special guests that we invited. We have a lot of special guests. We are all special, but I would really like to give credit to those who came from long distances. And please indulge me to mention one person in particular, Dr. Toluwaje, all the way from Ibadan. From the music department, University of Ibadan. He came by train this morning just to felicitate with us. Thank you very much, sir. God will continue to bless you. Thank you very much. The Joshua Okewo Foundation, Auntie Lola, thank you very, very much. This generosity is something we can never say enough thank you for. Thank you. May God continue to bless you. Our warm regards. Please help me appreciate them. Thank you very much. God bless you. Yes, and it is very, very important. If you look at the statistics of the choristers, you would see that we have a huge fraction of the younger ones. So I want to say a very big thank you to the parents of the choristers. Please, a round of applause for them. I make bold to say that this is the only choir in Lagos that practices four times in a week. They are very diligent. I overdrive them. Because after every rehearsal, I am tired. And they are always tired, but they never complain. Thank you. And I would also like to say a big thank you to the wives and the husbands of our choristers. Please, a round of applause for them. Thank you. Thank you. Our rehearsals close very late at times, and they keep coming back. It means they have permission to do so. Thank you very much. We appreciate you. God will continue to bless you. The elderly ones in the choir, please, I would like you to rise while we appreciate you. Thank you very much. Please. You are not elderly. Thank you very much. We appreciate you. Thank you very much for all your support and your guidance. I'd like to thank a chorister especially. Please permit me. I have a long list, like I said, but I'll be brief. Mr. Omoshebi, please stand up, sir. Mr. Omoshebi is a long-serving chorister in this church. And since I got here in 2019, I got to know him. He lives in the United States, but he has never missed the choir festival. He came in from US last night, and he joined us here today. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you. All organists and choir masters and choirs in the house, like I said initially, I'm overwhelmed. I am overwhelmed. I cannot mention all your names because I've seen a lot of people. Thank you very much. God will always honor you. Thank you very, very much. Please, a round of applause for them. And I think I can see the Sanus team, Sanus Domino. Those are the people that installed our brand new organ, the best organ in Nigeria. There it is. The only custom-made organ in Nigeria, from scratch to bottom. Sanus Domino built it for us according to our design and taste. Sanus Domino, thank you very much. God bless you. All right. The sound team and the ICT team, thank you. You've been here from the morning services. Oh, we've had five services. This is the fifth service we've had today. Thank you very much. God bless you. Our soloist, our guest soloist, Auntie Fumi Bokno, I guess she has left. She had a concert on Friday at Muson Center. It was lovely. She came around tonight. Please, let's applaud her. She has left, but let's appreciate her. Thank you very much. Mr. Abiodunjo, our guest organist who played the festival anthem for us, is a choir master and organist at Horace Memorial Methodist Church here in Sabu. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you. God bless you. A big thank you to Dr. Ayo Olurati, who composed Hail. I'm sure you love that song. He composed this specially for the Choir of All Saints, and this is the first time it is being heard anywhere in the world. Thank you very much, Dr. Olurati. I know you are watching us online. Thank you. Now, to the executives of the choir, you have been wonderful. You've been exceptional. And I am lucky to have you and work with every one of you. Thank you very much. Thank you. My able assistant organists, Mr. Henry, Segun Akimoladu, and Segun Babalola, please, let's clap for them. Thank you. I drive them more than I drive the choir. Every note has to be correct, and they are always on point. Thank you very much. God bless you. And yes, I must mention that Mr. Segun Akimoladu is the festival committee chairman, and he planned the whole program. Please come out and let them acknowledge you. Segun just returned from NYSC camp last week, but while he was in camp, he was always staying in touch and planning the success of this program. Thank you very much, Segun. God bless you. And finally, the choir. Please stand up. Please, they deserve more than that. Please. This is the best church choir in Nigeria. Thank you. I must give special recognition to my immediate predecessor, Mr. David Aino. He's right here. Mr. I took over from Mr. Eno in April, and from that time up till this time, Mr. Eno has never left the choir. He attends our rehearsals. He gives us support and everything. Mr. Eno, thank you very much, sir, for being a father and everything. God bless you. Finally, the brass team and the timpanists. You guys are wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. God bless you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Oh, we have some special awards we have to give to some choristers. And we'll do that very quickly. Now, some of these awards are singing awards, but we just don't look at the singing aspect. We look at many things that are attached to the choristers that brings success to the choir. Punctuality, enthusiasm, which is paramount for me. And I'll just go through the list. We have Best Soprano for this year. We have Faith Ohima. And I would like to call Ms. Akinshola to make that presentation to her. Thank you, sir.
For being the best soprano for the year, this award is presented to Faith Ohima. I pray you will continue to sing and edify God's name. Congratulations.
Best alto for the year. Well, before I mention this person's name, I have to say something about him. He's a music director of his own church. And I must mention, okay, I will still come to that. He's a music director of his own church, but he's so passionate about the music in All Saints, he left his church to join this choir. And I'm talking about no other person but my own brother, my older brother, Mr. Tony Olagun. I would like to call on Mrs. Adekunle to help us with the presentation.
On behalf of All Saints Church, Yaba, I present this to you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Okay, best tenor for the year. This man is so passionate about choir. He is always ready to come to rehearsal. If we rehearse 7 times a week, Charles will be around. Charles Akinini. I would like to call on Mr. Orife. Please help us make the presentation, sir. Thank you, sir.
Charles. On behalf of the church and the choir master and music director, I present to you this award for the best tenor, for the year 2022. If you do better than this next year, you may get another award. But this is supposed to give you more motivation to perform better. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. And the best bass for the year 2022. He is currently the oldest serving member of the choir, Mr. Beckley. Pa Akinlawo Beckley. Please, let's stand as we welcome Mr. Beckley. Now, I must say that this is not based on sentiment. Mr. Beckley is a wonderful singer. I'd like to invite Dr. Woman to please help us present the awards.
Congratulations on this award, and well done. Just keep on keeping doing the best that you can. Well done.
Thank you, sir. Now, there are two more awards. The most outstanding chorister. This man is a unique person. We found each other on Facebook. He's a follower of the choir on Facebook. And he used to be the organist and choir master of his church. That's the thing about Onsays Choir. You just must love the choir. You will leave your church to join us. And then he messaged me on Facebook and he said, I would like to be a part of your choir. He attended Warrior Hazard and he left his church to sing in this choir. And he has not been just a singer. The music school of the choir, this man comes to take the classes every Tuesday and Thursday at no cost. And this award goes to Mr. Victor. Please, let's start with Victor. Victor, thank you. I would like to call on Mr. Shem Owaji to help us present this award. Uncle Shem, thank you, sir.
Okay, Mr. Victor Oguegede, right? Okay, this most outstanding chorister award is being awarded to you because of your diligence and your patriotism to this choir. And the Lord sees your labor of love and will reward you in Jesus' name. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. And the final award, while I was organist of the church, is an award I decided to give to choristers for excellence and support and determination for the growth of the choir. So last year it was Organist Award, this year it's now Choir Masters Award, and that award goes to no other person but Mr. Tunde Bucknor. Like I said, you just have to love the choir of All Saints. Tunde shares a similar story. He used to be a chorister on the island, a paid chorister. But he came back to All Saints and he has been a very big motivation to the choir. He's very supportive. Sometimes I think his wala is too much. But Tunde, thank you for everything. Yes, I would like to call on the sub-organist of the cathedral at Christ Church Cathedral Marina, Mr. Jola Adeosun, to make this presentation. Please, let's clap for Mr. Jola. He's my organ.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, I present to you the Choir Masters Award, Mr. Babatunde Maxwell Bucknor. Congratulations.
Thank you very much for your patience. God bless you.
Praise ye the Lord. I will want you to do a thing to express gratitude to God for the way this choir have ministered this evening by giving us just 2.5 minutes to arrange ourselves for a group photograph here. The choir, can we arrange ourselves? The clergy, let's join them, please. Let's arrange ourselves for a group photograph. The clergy, those who are tallest, will flank them. The chaplain and the cantor will stand beside the choir master. Let's quickly arrange ourselves. Once again, we appreciate all of you and the patience that you have demonstrated in praising God along with us. We recognize our special guest from the best university in Nigeria, Dr. Dr. Tolu Owoaje is all the way from the best university in Nigeria. Who knows that university? The best university in Nigeria is the university that gave birth to all universities in Nigeria. He's a lecturer in the University of Ibadan. We are glad to have you, sir. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Our sister who represents benevolent Oyelolu, we are glad to have you. God bless you in the name of Jesus. The youth choir, God bless you in the name of Jesus. Every chorister of various in this service, you are highly recognized. Our brothers from Christ Church Cathedral Marina, we appreciate you. Reverend Akinade, Reverend Ade Oshun, and some other priests in the service, we appreciate you. I think Oluwatope Olaguju and his assistant, they deserve our commendation. They have done well, they have tried. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. We appreciate every one of you. God bless you for all that you do. God bless you in Jesus' name.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you. I remain with you always.